Hello and welcome to part two of the second of the three weekly lessons about Oracle Jet. In the first part of this lesson, you were introduced to the theme for this week, which is to explore Oracle Jet's features, use cases, and scenarios. The first area we'll be exploring is the Oracle Jet data visualization component set. These are the most visually appealing parts of Oracle Jet, as well as some of the more complex. You're likely to want to get familiar with them as a first step after getting to know the basic concepts of JET, which we dealt with in the first week of this course. Let's start by looking at the charts. You can use charts to present flat or hierarchical data in a graphical display for data analysis.
As an example, let's put a chart into the employees module that we created earlier. In the cookbook, find a chart of your liking. For example, let's take a look at the picture chart. This is a relatively new chart in the Oracle Jet component library and is especially useful for representing statistics. Copy the section of the cookbook that is relevant for the view as a starting point and paste it into the employee's HTML file. Save it and then take note of the data that is represented by the chart, in this case represented by means of the picture chart items observable array. Paste it into the JavaScript side of the module. Make sure to refer to the Oracle Jet component that you're making use of, which is the picture chart, and then simply open the browser and you will see that your chart is displayed there. You can go a step further and try and copy more of the code from the recipe that might be relevant for your context. For example, the display data that is put next to it, paste it into the view, and then go back into the browser and you will see your data together with the legend or text next to it. Finally, make sure that you're familiar with all the variations on the charts that you choose. There might be some features that could be really relevant for your context without you being aware of it. So when you are getting familiar with the different charts, spend some time browsing through all the different ways in which charts can be visualized and represented within your JET application. You will see that each recipe within the cookbook has a wide range of documentation and options and events and configurations for you to examine.
Next, let's take a look at the gauges. The gauges provided by Oracle JET are lead gauge, rating gauge, and status meter gauge, among others. For example, rating gauges are typically used to display or accept feedback on a product or a service, while lead gauges are used to highlight a specific metric value in relation to its threshold.
Let's go through the same steps as before as a revision to add a gauge to our About module. We go into the gauge section, status meter gauge, and notice that there is a circular variation on the status meter gauge, which can be very useful. Very common type of gauge that you see in many applications. And in there, we see in the view, the HTML tag that defines a circular status meter gauge. We copy it into our view. We notice that there is a two-way data binding code, value 10. We copy it from the recipe and we paste it. And also, we look for the OJ gauge component reference and paste it into our define block. In our view, there is another reference to a one-way data binding called label. We look inside of our JavaScript in the recipe and we paste that property into the view model as well. Back in our application, we can see that our gauge is now rendered correctly using the data we have provided simply by copying and pasting from the cookbook.
The Oracle Jet component library includes a thematic map component, which is especially useful for showing data with geographic locations. Several built-in maps are included, as well as support for GeoJSON, which is the official format for encoding a variety of geographic data structures. Included in the Oracle Jet component library is a timeline component, which displays a set of events in chronological order. The timeline component includes advanced and sophisticated features, such as a rich support for graphical data rendering, scale manipulation, zooming, resizing, and object grouping. To round off our exploration of the data visualization components, let's take a look at the Tag Cloud component. Tag clouds display textual data, where font style and size are used to emphasize the importance of each data item. Other data visualization components to be aware of include the diagram, inbox, sunburst, and tree map. It should also be noted that all of these data visualization components meet the WCAG 2.0 standard. This is important when building applications for the enterprise space. In this part, you have been introduced to the data visualization components. You have learned that each component has basic features, as well as a range of options that you can use to customize them. Each component has events, which let you connect the HTML view to the business logic in JavaScript. The cookbook provides complete recipes for each component, as well as a link to the related JavaScript documentation. For your homework for this part, choose one or two chart recipes in the cookbook, review the JS docs pages for the particular charts that you've chosen, and try and tweak them live in the browser and see what the effect is. As a bonus task, also try adding a gauge component and an input field to one of your JET applications and bind them together so that changing the input field updates the gauge, and updating the gauge changes the value in the input field. Finally, thank you once again for participating in the course on Oracle JET, and we hope that you're learning a lot, and we look forward to seeing you again in the next part.